What's the seabird up to? We'll find out with Seabird Secrets. Unlike other members of the auk family, black guillemots lay 2 eggs instead of just 1. This is where a black guillemot's life usually begins, in a rock crevice or under some driftwood, where it's protected from predators and the elements. Both parents share feeding duties, and their diet mainly consists of fish and crustaceans, but mollusks, insects, and plant material can also find their way into a guillemot's belly. These birds forage underwater, mostly staying within 30 feet of the surface, but on rare occasions can dive deeper than 100 feet. When a chick is 4 to 8 weeks old, it's time to leave the nest. It usually leaves on its own before it even learns how to fly. During cold winters, the recognizable breeding plumage is replaced with whitish feathers to blend in with its surroundings. Some birds will stay close to shore while others move out to sea. A guillemot will usually begin breeding when it's around 4 years old. In the spring, a pair may return to the same breeding grounds year after year, and are usually monogamous. Black guillemots face challenges outside of the natural world as well. To find out more, I spoke with the Seabird Institute's Susan Schubel, also known as Seabird Sue.
Could you talk about one threat that black guillemots face?
One threat that black guillemots face is the problem of marine debris. So there's a lot of garbage that washes up from the oceans and gets tossed onto their nesting islands. If they poke into something that shouldn't be there, a lobster trap or a bunch of garbage, some ropes, they might get tangled up and not be able to get back out again.
Sue also explained why balloons are dangerous to seabirds.
And it's not the balloons so much, although that is a danger to a lot of animals because they could eat them, but the ribbons attached to the balloons for burrow nesting birds really cause a lot of entanglement issues.
So how has Audubon Seabird Institute been working to combat this issue of marine debris?
One thing that we did, we got a NOAA grant to help clean up the marine debris on some of our seabird islands. So we picked up everything from tiny rubber ducks to tossed up mangled lobster traps, lots of fishing gear, plastic bottles, cups. So here we're working really quickly to fill up that dumpster, about 2.25 tons worth of debris. And we still had more that we took off on a barge. It's amazing how quickly and relentlessly that debris comes back. But for a little while, we made a big difference.
And what's one thing we can all do to protect these seabirds?
Marine debris comes from places even far inland. So if you don't live next to the ocean and you think you're off the hook, all rivers lead to the sea. So I think if we reduce, reuse, recycle, mainly reduce.
Thanks, Seabird Sue, for sharing some seabird secrets this episode. For more on seabirds and ways you can get involved, check out our website,